Hello, my name is Abe, and welcome back to the Darkest Dungeon. On the last mission, we completed the courtyard. Well, not the entirety of the courtyard. We completed the most recent courtyard mission, which was to kill the Viscount. We currently have this one mission, and we have an invitation for it. I don't understand it. If we want, we could go and fight the Countess right now, but I worry a little bit that this might be one of those missions where it kind of drops you in to the boss fight immediately, because it's kind of strange that previously for the other courtyard missions we've had to collect invitations. Right now we have one. It seems a little strange to me, so I think I'm just going to ignore it for now. Come back to it in a bit once I can get people, you know, get some negative quirks on my sort of A-team courtyard killing squad removed. Get some positive quirks locked in or something, and then we'll go to the courtyard later. But for now, we still need to fight a boss in the ruins and a couple of bosses in the Weld, so we will go and do our best to try to unlock those boss fights. So I think today I'm going to go to the Weld, do a long veteran level mission, take a random assortment squad of people who I want leveled up, including Duhamel, the Flagellant, Janie, our Vestal, Tortval, our Bounty Hunter, and Montfort, our Man-at-Arms. I want to get him leveled up because he has hard skin, which is an awesome trait to have, and I would like to lock that in the future. I think this will be a relatively straightforward mission. We can camp, we can relieve a little bit of stress with the Flagellant, and otherwise, you know, we're just gonna go on, move on, have a good time. I don't need six keys. We'll take two. We'll take one. We'll take one just in case we find a secret room. And we'll take a medicinal herb, a bandage, an anti-venom, a holy water, and that's it. And then, you know, food and torches and a stack of shovels and all that good stuff. Everyone has trinkets. Everyone has their necessary skills unlocked and upgraded fully, or as much as they can be. I need to get these people leveled up before they can have their equipment or skills upgraded any further. But I fully expect this to be a relatively straightforward mission.
I knew all these paths once. Now they are as twisted as my own ambitions.
Twisted.
Yeah, I fully expect this to be a relatively straightforward mission. As long as the Man-at-Arms isn't too underleveled for the area, and as long as we don't get super stressed, I will try to collect as many gems, gold, heirlooms as I can. We might as well go down first, because we are going to have to backtrack. This is going to be a long level. It's going to be long, but hopefully it's not going to be terribly difficult. We might as well use the medicinal herbs. This isn't the cove, you know, there's not going to be a opportunity for us to relieve, or remove, I should say, negative quirks by using medicinal herbs. We might as well just kind of use those as we get them. I brought along a bandage and anti-venom just because I thought maybe we could use them. The people here are relatively weak to bleed, so the Flagellant works pretty well. The Flagellant's bleed is pretty heavy as well. You know, this guy, oh, he's not dead. I thought he would be, but I guess he's dead next turn. If the Man-at-Arms, if the Flagellant get attacked, it doesn't matter. I like the Flagellant, I just don't understand how to use them all that well. We could buff our dodge and speed, but instead I think I'm just going to go for an attack. Does he have a damage upgrade? Yeah, okay. So, the candle will improve his damage. His damage is quite low, but, you know, this is not a super high-leveled squad here. We're going to see some lower numbers than we were last time. Good. I like it when the Flagellant gets hit. I still worry. I worry about him a lot because he could just heal over and die if he gets hit a couple of times, but I don't know, maybe we'll figure out how to make him work.
Masterfully executed.
As we keep playing, we'll sort of learn a little bit more about him. He is actually in range to use his heal for the next turn, which is pretty nice. We might as well just collect bounty.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
A faint hope blossoms.
Yep. You dodged. That's unfortunate. And of course he gets crit. Well, I mean, he's gonna heal himself nearly to full on the next turn. And he gets a bonus right now. So here it goes.
The ground quakes.
You crit healed and you crit
hit. Weakened.
Get out of here with that. Yeah, you know, with trinkets, with the provisions we have, I don't really foresee this being terribly difficult. But really, I just want to have a lot of gold coming out of this mission. I want to have a lot of loot. I want to have, ideally, the man-at-arms level up maybe once, maybe twice. And otherwise, we're just going to continue on here. There's going to be another encounter here in a second.
In Radiance, may we find victory.
Quivering ectoplasms. I don't see them very often, but I guess I don't come down to the Weld all that often. Which I suppose is why it is hurting for levels. We need to do two more boss fights down here.
Confidence surges as the enemy
Confidence
crumbles.
Surges! Ah, you might as well hit him. I've got the Vestal because I really do want another high-leveled Vestal. I only have one, but I have two high-leveled occultists, which is kind of strange. You know, you would probably rather have a Vestal over occultist, so we are going to have to slowly work our way towards getting our Vestals upgraded. I do have a map. Put the map on the Bounty Hunter Tortival. So hopefully we'll be able to, you know, find a lot of traps, avoid them, find some secret rooms, get a whole bunch of gold coming out of this. So I brought that key along. You might as well, you know, 120 base plus 20. We might as well flashbang him now. The Bounty Hunter has a better chance of landing it, and we can buff our speed, maybe get in another attack before the Collector moves, and if we have good luck, kill him before he can do anything. Because the bleed stacking from the Flagellant might be enough to finish the job if we get, like, one lucky crit with someone.
Precision and power.
We could do it. That's 10 damage. No. No. Oh, yes! Yes! There's the lucky crit. We killed the occultist. Not the occultist. Nah, don't kill my occultist. But we killed the,
Triumphant precipitates.
Whatever this guy is. The Collector. Killed the Collector before he could even move. Dude, that is awesome. Don't touch the food. It's not actually food. It's fake food. Blighted Giant. So we could mark him and go to town, or we could go after the dog. I think we should go after the dog. 140%, so we've got a 70% chance of stunning the giant. I think we take it. Good. Oh, the move happened as well. We mark the giant. You know what? The only person who synergizes with marking is the Bounty Hunter. And it only gives him a 90% bonus to his damage. We might as well just use him to attack something. And we might as well kill the Crone and the Gnasher here. Try to knock these guys out. Yeah, knock the dog out. Oh, Vestal! Chaney, you suck!
The slow death.
Is she gonna move first? Nope.
Unforgiving.
I really want to put the bleed on the giant, but we should probably kill the Crone first. I think it's kind of lucky that we managed to get our attack in before this big guy.
Impressive critical hit, yes.
Maybe I should have used the Vestal to heal there, but you know, as long as we don't get tree branch smacked down, which is the only ability apparently I've seen this guy ever use. Oh my god, that's what I was worried about. Fucking crit him. For like 35 points of damage, good god. Well, I mean, hopefully we move first before the giant. Stun him. Nope. Heal. Oh, thank God. Man-at-arms, how the hell did you get crit for 35? Poison spores, that's something else. Doesn't he also have like a confusion attack, I want to say? There we go, he's stunned. Man-at-arms is back in his original position. We'll have one turn where we can recover a little bit from that stupid crit. Might as well mark him. Because I'm not attacking him this turn. I'm not killing him this turn. We're just frickin' buffing ourselves with speed. Doing a lot of healing. Because we need it. God damn it. Yes! Okay, good. Very glad the Vestal moved before anyone else. Because now we can get the kill.
Prodigious size alone does not dissuade
the well, that sucks. I got this extra stack of food, so I'm just going to use it all, take the gold. Survival guide is interesting, but we already have one of those. And we're gonna have the flagellant look at this, because the flagellant, if he gets stressed out from seeing a dead body or something, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter because he is... Ah, get rid of the bandage. Doesn't matter because he is just going to relieve his own stress when we camp. Because he's got a really nice ability that removes 50 points of stress basically instantly. It's pretty damn great. He's actually quite efficient at reducing his own stress. He also has an ability which increases his stress. I don't know why you would ever want to use it. I haven't figured that part out yet. So this might mark two people. I mean, honestly, if you're gonna, you know, crit, tree, branch, smack down anybody, I would prefer it to be the flagellant. So the fact that he is currently targeted is not that big of a problem for me. 69%, 74%. Higher chance, and it has killing damage, so we are gonna use that first. Oh, and then he can freaking bleed the crone. What is the death store penalty? Accuracy damage, 1 speed, and then plus 10 damage. That's not that bad. Wow, you guys suck. No one can frickin' kill the crone. His stress doesn't matter. There we go. You know, I'd prefer it if he could eat the stress of everyone else. So maybe if I get another turn with the flagellant, I'll just have him suck up the stress from the man-at-arms. Another crit from the Vestal? I can't complain about that at all. Oh, I didn't suck up the stress, damn it. Whole reason why I really wanted to have the flagellant go first. I mean, it's not that big of a deal because when we camp, we can always use stress healing abilities, but ideally I'd like to, you know, hold off on camping for a while. All right. Don't crit him. That's even better. Don't even hit him. You suck at this. Well, we might as well heal.
Wounds of war can be healed.
And we might as well suck up stress. The bounty hunter can get the kill.
A victory. Perhaps the turning point.
And we get one more holy water. I mean, maybe that'll make him feel better. You know, I wish it would, but probably not. There we go, perfect. So the fact that he has increased his stress doesn't really bother me all that much because we can reduce it when we camp. We might want to camp a little bit earlier than I would have liked, but that's fine. Quivering ectoplasm. We gotta kill the small guy first. Resisted the bleed. I mean, honestly, that's not that unexpected. But we gotta kill the big guy first, because the big guy gets cytokinesis. Cytokinesis is bad, because that means he will spawn more slime dudes. And the small slimes we want to kill first, because they can spawn a big slime dude. Towering ectoplasm. And we would prefer that doesn't happen. Luckily, though, this guy's just doing big slime, which is a really bad attack. Buff our speed, maybe have one more action available to us. I don't really know what I was planning on doing with that, but hey, we got it. Intrinsic merit. We got it!
Unless inordinate exsanguination be considered a virtue.
Blah, 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 blah. And because this is an explore 90% of rooms, we will have to go to all these rooms, even though there's no combat to them. I mean, not all of them, but we might as well, you know? Might as well leave that for the way back. Probably not gonna get any loot out of this because it's just spiders. Spiders and maggots. Just don't crit. No one's marked, so you can't kill anybody in one turn.
Such a terrible assault.
That sucks a little bit from stress. I should probably camp at some point because I don't... Oh, okay. Well, the crit kill makes me feel a lot better. But I should probably think about camping at some point so that I can help reduce people's stress. We have two logs. We have plenty of food. Maybe I'll do that on the way back. You know, don't use any torches until we get all the way back. Oh my god.
Are often low on supplies.
Whatever, use the torch. Don't use the torches, and you know, on the way back, whatever, use a torch. We're gonna be a little bit low for torches, but whatever. We could use a key. I'm gonna save the key though. I'm gonna save the key just in case we. It's fine. Just in case we run into a secret room. Not super likely to happen, but it could. Do a little bit of inventory management while we walk through these rooms, going back to where we were. Puzzling trapezohedron, that's gonna be kept. You know, we might as well try to open the luggage. You know, if we get blighted, if we get bled, who cares? Who cares, really? Now, I know they probably care a little bit. You know what? Sure. You got rabies. I mean, minus 10 accuracy plus 15% damage is not the worst thing in the world. You know, accuracy is very important and all that, but he can actually remove a disease by camping. So what we could do is do a little bit of exploration, then camp, then have him remove his disease and heal his own stress by 50 points, and we'll be good as new. Not quite good as new, but nearly good as new. Yes, touch the tree. I want him to get low on HP so that he can open up combat using his exsanguinate ability. And I don't really want to use another torch, especially if we're going to camp soon. I mean, I used a torch by accident. I've been playing a lot of Enter the Gungeon and I remapped the map to T. And so I pressed T trying to open the map when I should have pressed Tab like an idiot.
Well struck.
Whoops. Whoops. You're not dead. Now you are. Sucks that we have to have two attacks being used there, but honestly, that's not that bad. And with 50% protection, I really should be stunning these fungal grabbers. Don't crit. Crits are bad for stress. I don't really care about the damage. We can heal from that. But if they just miss all the damn time, that's good. I approve. No one can actually hit the guy in the back, which is very unfortunate, so we are gonna kinda have to focus down these fungals, grabbers and scratchers. But we can also try to knock him back. If we can knock him back too, maybe we can kill his friend? No, the knockback's only 1 point. Well, the Vestal can kill this fungal battery in 10 years. Third position? Super easy to kill. Back position? Not all that easy to kill. You know, another thing I can do is shuffle this guy. By shuffling up, he's now in a position where I can hit him. Aha, smart thinking. I wish I thought of that sooner. And you might as well get the kill. He's got relatively high speed. Was it the stun for this turn or for the last turn? I can't remember. you missed. And you're not even the one with rabies. And yet you still missed. You're the one with rabies. You might as well kill him. It's unfortunate that he won't get the stress relief from the killing blow, but that's okay. That's okay. And if there is a hallway combat here, what we could do is we could reduce our torchlight and then get into combat. We have a very small chance of having the Shambler come out and attack us, but we could also get a little bit of extra loot, and then we can go camp. Although if it is the Shambler, we're gonna be in a lot of trouble. I want you to open with Exsanguinate on the next fight, so I want you to kill him. And you can buff us for the next fight. You can kill him. I was worried coming down here that the Vestal's stress might get a little bit out of control, but honestly, it's been fine. So yeah, you know what? Let's just pitch black it. Much worse than mere trickery. Walk forward. Okay. Oh, there's a Shambler's Altar. I'm not gonna do it, but there's a Shambler's Altar. We'll just kill these guys instead. I mean, we can finish them. Or we could shuffle them. Or we could just kill the big guy. Let's kill the big guy. If we exsanguinate him, he's not gonna last long. He's bleeding for 8. One more hit will kill him. Even with the +3 speed, you still go last. There we go. So the big guy's dead. And that's pretty good. But yeah, we definitely need to camp and deal with stress. Death by inches. Oh, and he can exsanguinate again. Fuck, dude. Oh, and the Vestal picks up the kill. We might as well stun him. It's got a 95% chance of landing. Yeah, 95%. Oh, and the finish him. Destroyed. The stun into the finish him. It's good. Foolish horrors.
Brought low and driven into the mud.
600 gold. We can't take it, but we are going to get rid of some. No. Can't take it, but we are going to get rid of some inventory space right about now. We'll camp. We will.
In the dark. The battle may yet be won.
I'm going to full. Just because stress is not going to be a problem because we're going to relieve it. We sanctuary. If mortality debuffs, heals, and minus stress on the man-at-arms. So actually, that's pretty good because that means that we're going to get that again the next time we use sanctuary, next time we camp. You're gonna remove 50 stress, remove a disease. Don't ask how flagellating yourself cures your diseases, but you know, whatever works. Plus accuracy and dodge, or all companions plus damage and crit. Let's do that. And with one respite point remaining, I can increase his stress by 40. That's dumb.
The match is struck.
Good.
A blazing star is born.
Mr. Man-at-Arms, look at the fountain. Relieved one stress. Sure. Yes, I was expecting something a little bit better than that, but that works too. I was hoping for a buff like better dodge chance. Less chance of being stressed in the future, I don't know. Anything. I really don't like the idea of secret room, good. I really don't like the idea of doing a run that is pitch black. And it's specifically because of the damn Shambler. That guy's a pain in the ass. And if you don't really have a good squad created for dealing with him, you could find yourself, you know, getting party wiped. You get surprised, you have a squad that can't really reposition themselves easily, can't hit the Shambler, can't kill the clapper claws that he spawns, and then all of a sudden, get everyone wounded, everyone dies. Like, I just don't like the idea of doing that. I'd much prefer to fight him like through an altar. It would be really cool if you could appease the Shambler by fighting him every once in a while, and then if you don't do that, he'll come after you, kind of like the Fanatic. But as it is right now, that's too much of a risk. I was hoping that would kill, but at least it stunned him. It's too much of a risk. -2 accuracy. I mean, that's like not a lot of an accuracy penalty. Oh, and he still moved first. His speed is 4. That's bullshit. I'll bullshit on that. You might as well get the kill on the front guy, because the back guy is so damn weak, anything will kill him, including Rampart. Which should have killed him on the last turn, but whatever.
As victories mount, so too will resistance.
We're not really finding that much resistance, though. This is pretty straightforward. There's a chest. However, music gets a lot more intense when the light is low, it seems like. It's pretty nice.
Sedated.
Might as well kill one of these ectoplasms. If they cytokinesis, whatever. It's the ectoplasmic perfusion which is a problem, because that's the one that spawns a big guy. No bleed, damn. And no debuff, so the chance of the bleed's gonna be low. Or a chance of future bleed. The crit is fine. You can exsanguinate, hopefully. No, wait a minute. We gotta kill the small guys, then we kill the big guy. I remember now! We'll weaken the big guy so we can kill him quickly, but we gotta kill the small ones. Crit for 20. You know, kinda wish I had hit the back guy, but can't complain. Can we stun him? We got like a 70% chance of a stun. It feels like when you crit, you have a better chance of stunning. I don't know why, maybe that's on purpose? Maybe that's true and accurate, or maybe I'm just kind of mistaken and misremembering things, but it definitely feels like you have a better chance of stunning on a crit. The front guy is gonna be dead in 2 turns. Let's kill the big guy. Or the front guy is gonna be dead now. Slime smack. Good. No cytokinesis. It's unfortunate that he's stunned, but he can open up the next combat with a exsanguinate, so I don't worry about him at all. In fact, no. He's fine. The purpose of the flagellant is to use their exsanguinate and their heals and the fact that they like having low HP, right? Right?
But a victory nonetheless.
So I've gotta start abusing that and using it more. What better time to start than now? Okay, you touch the food. There's still some meat on these bones. 2 food. I mean, it's better than nothing. I guess we're gonna go into the next combat with no light. Which honestly,
secrets and wonders
that's not what I wanted. Which honestly is fine for me. Oh, there's another combat that spawned here. But they're surprised with a purple icon. Finish the bat guy. I guess our damage is higher, isn't it? Yeah. No, crit chance is higher, damage is the same. Does the exsanguinate have a higher chance of landing the bleed? No. Same chance. And then 40%. Unlikely to get the stun. Let's just kill him. But you know, a little bit of low lights. Not so bad, especially when we're at full health and relatively little stress. I mean, the crit sucked, but. Yeah, I'm not gonna go out of my way too much. Do low light stuff. Especially not when we are doing room combat. Room combat, it doesn't matter because it can never be the Shambler. Hallway combat is what can sometimes be the Shambler. That's a ton of gold. Unfortunately, I have to drop stuff to carry it. Should I drop the torches? Sure. Drop the torches, carry all the gold.
We require only the strength to follow it.
Drop the shovels? No, let's keep the shovels. Drop the 600 gold. We're gonna get so much money from the secret room. We're not gonna worry about money. 3-4. It's not likely to get a kill. Oh, right. Crush does land that far. I keep forgetting that Crush can hit the third position. Unfortunately, it didn't land enough damage to kill, but whatever. I'm just gonna let the... I'm gonna let the Vestal get the kill, but we'll just get it ourselves. She can attack the Crone and do a surprising amount of damage. I'm always surprised by the upper range of the Vestal's attack damage. That was Confusion Spores, yep. There goes our light level. Can the Vestal recover that? Yeah, she has Illumination. We should probably end up using that at some point. Yeah, I mean, the crit's fine. It did stun, so I definitely approve. Yeah, maybe we should try to do like one Illumination on the Crone or something. We could try to flashbang the Crone, but... Oh, Illumination's in the third position. Dazzling Light is from fourth position. We gotta change her skills up a little bit.
The wounds of war can be healed.
Yeah, can be healed. Hidden. Can be healed when we're kicking ass. Not really kicking ass. I mean, we're surviving at this point. He's gonna get another attack. I'm not gonna be able to stun him, I don't think. You actually freaking missed. Poison spores. At least it's not a crit tree branch smackdown that will put you on death's door immediately. I'm just gonna heal him. Do a targeted heal. I don't care about the flagellant because he can heal himself. At least I don't care about the flagellant as much, maybe. 1 point of damage. Get the kill. Cover some stress. No, no stress at all.
This expedition at least
don't want the crest, don't want the busts. We're gonna be coming down the hallway though because, obstacles, good thing I kept the frickin' shovels. We're gonna be coming down this hallway though because of the secret door, so we can open the chest after we camp and
nature herself
recover a little bit of inventory space, and if we're lucky, we can get a little bit of extra loot.
Malformed.
The beast will fight harder in the dark.
Yeah. Well, so will we, right? Right? It definitely feels like the music gets more intense in the dark, which is nice. You know, I miss having a little bit of epic music happening. Well, there goes the light. Down to 12. It's a lot harder to see things in the dark, though. We get this, like, red hue over everything. Plus plus monster accuracy and damage. Plus plus player crit when we hit the darkest, right? No, just plus 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 loot. Why did I think it was plus plus plus? Or plus plus for, player crit? Maybe it is, and I'm mistaken. Or maybe it's not. Friggin' monsters are harder, though. Alright, so you're dead, because you're stunned. Stress is starting to build, but we can camp and feast. And we can use the flagellant to suck up stress when we can. Not gonna do that right now, though. So this is a guaranteed stun. I think we do it. We do the other stun. Oh my god, that sucks. We do the other stun with the man-at-arms. Which has like a 95% chance of landing. And then we spend a turn just killing these grabbers. The one in the back can stumbling scratch forward if we kill his friend. Buff to crit and damage. Go ahead. So now he's debuffed, which I don't like, but nothing really I can do about it. Still don't quite... Oh, no. She's going to die first, and then he's not going to be able to do Stumbling Scratch is the like, cultist brawlers. The guys who have, like, the Wolverine gauntlets on. They're the ones who do the Stumbling Scratch, if I remember correctly. You're not going to get stunned. You'll hopefully die, though. Yeah. One more point of damage will do it. Will we move first? Probably. Good. Decent amount of loot that I can't keep. Slow and insidious killer. A shovel. Let's do that on the way back. Just in case I want to, you know, drop some inventory space like other shovels. Stress is okay. You know, these people, they're... Oh, continue adventuring. They're most likely to get some time off after this mission anyways, and they can just get passive stress recovery in the hamlet. I don't really even need to pay for it. We have a shovel, so there's not going to be a negative consequence from doing this, but I'll have the flagellant do it anyways. It's good practice. Let's drop two shovels to take the crests. Let's not worry about the jade. With these two chests, I don't think we need to worry about dropping other things. Oh, rubies. Yes, now we'll drop the food. Pop the holy healing water. Yeah, reds turn into purples, I guess, in the pitch black. In the pitch of black. And honestly, we might even do this hallway just to get a little bit of stress relief on the bounty hunter, because he will get stress relief from disarming the trap. And it's a torch, which I guess we should do. Let's explore a little bit, you know? Look at the next curio room. Look at the next hallway encounter here. There's nothing here except curios. But we're gonna be full on loot anyways. Let's get the hell out of here. All right. Anything in the torch? Three pieces of paper. We don't need. Camp. We've got food and a key in our inventory, and that's it. That's like perfect. Feast. Reduce stress. A goal without hope. You are going to remove 50 stress. You're going to sanctuary. You're going to reduce her stress. You are going to... I guess that's all we can do. One companion, reduce stress by, if not religious, reduce stress by 5. So theoretically, we can reduce the bounty hunter's stress by a couple of points. That's about it. So we might as well do that. There we go, -7, not even 5.
As the light gains purchase,
open the chest. It's trapped. Oh no! If only we had a key. Clear. Oh wait. We're using the key on the secret door. And key, don't forget to use it. Drop the food, take the money, leave.
Paths and roads bring soldiers and supplies. Let them arrive unharried.
30,000 gold plus another 11,000 from the mission, 12 crests from the mission, 18 crests, 6 busts, 6 deeds. Slowly working towards the ability to hard-skinned on Chaney, nice. Slowly working towards the ability to build some good districts. I could have built one before going out on this mission, but I didn't. It's like the one that gives you 10% base so well stress heal for people who are waiting.
Barely whispered aloud in town. By decent folk.
Kleptomaniac removed from Mobek, which needs to be done, because damn, Kleptomaniac is not a fun one to have. And we did get a boss fight unlocked. So this is going to give us a Vestal Scroll, better healing skills, lower speed, lower damage, which, I mean, this is not a very good trinket, but we might as well do it because it's a trinket that we don't have. and none of the other trinkets in the other mission areas look all that good. Ancestor's handkerchief, I do want to pick up all of the Ancestor's gear, but we do have the option for doing a boss fight, so I think we'll do that. Brigand 12 pounder. Wait, 12 pounder? 8, 12, 6. This is a veteran level mission, veteran level boss fight? Are you kidding me? I did not realize that. I thought we had done all of the veteran level boss fights. Okay. Well, knowing that now, we're going to slightly adjust our plans. We're going to have a leper. We're going to have a healer. We're going to have a herbalist. And we're probably going to have either the grave robber or the highwayman. I do like the riposte on the highwayman. But better damage on the Grave Robber, I think, is what we want. Now, the Blight skill, I don't really care about, but I think having a Grave Robber would be better because we're going to have a very high accuracy. Hit the Fusilier, someone else can hit him if we don't kill him, and then we can just go from there.
Yeah.
This is okay. We could just do a marking party and mark the tank. I don't have an occultist for that, but I could, instead of bringing along the leper, bring along the bounty hunter. And then we can mark the tank, and we can use our plus damage skills against it whenever we have the opportunity. I actually do like that idea. So I think this is the party we'll rock with going to the Weld. Until then, thank you very much for watching. Like the video if you enjoyed it, subscribe for more, and I hope to see you here for the next mission in the Darkest Dungeon.